Hello, this is Mr. Gilmore with the 3.6 Part 1 Congruence Application Problems. These last two lessons are going to be how can we use our congruence to help us reach conclusions about things. Today you're going to see just some generic problems, and in the next lesson, 3.6 Part 2, we're going to see some applications in proof. So let's take a look at what we're going to be doing today with some application problems of congruence. Here's the task at hand. On the next several slides, I'm going to chuck two triangles at you. These two triangles, I am going to ask you each time, are they congruent? Meaning, can you provably show that these two triangles are congruent? And I'm going to ask you how they are congruent, meaning you're going to give me the reason why, either with side angle side, side side side, or angle side angle. Those are our three triangle congruent shortcuts. If there is not enough information for us then to prove that those triangles are in fact congruent, then we'll use NEI, short for not enough information. Let's take a look at our first example. So we have two triangles here, ABC, DEF. The question is, are they congruent? Meaning, can we satisfy one of our shortcuts of triangle congruence? In this case, the answer is yes. We can actually prove these two triangles are congruent, and the reason why is side-side-side congruence. We know that the three sides of the first triangle are congruent and equal to the three sides of the second, which means then these two triangles have to be congruent. So this is how you're going to see the rest of these slides unfold. I'm going to chuck two triangles with some information about them, and you're going to tell me either yes or no, or yes, no, or not enough information. So let's take a look at these two. In my triangles ABC and DEF, I have angle A and D are equal, angle B and E are equal, and the sides BC and EF are equal. So this one actually is angle, angle, side. So that's the question, angle, angle, side. Is that congruent? Well, as of right now, we haven't proven angle, angle, side. So our answer for this one is simply going to be NEI, not enough information for us at this point in time. If we proved angle, angle, side as a theorem, then yes, we could say yes. So technically, we'll say this in little parentheses, it's a future yes. Okay, it's a future yes. We will actually then be able to prove these guys congruent. How about these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle BDC? Note that they have a common side, which means common sides always mean equal sides. So AB and AC and BD and CD are given to us as equal. So can we prove these two triangles are congruent? Yes. And the reason why? Again, side, side, side congruence. How about these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle DEF? A lot of students, their gut feeling is just say yes. And the reason why is they'll say is because they look congruent. We can't say that. Here's the thing. The three sides of this triangle ABC, yes, are equal. And the three sides of this triangle DEF, yes, they're equal. But are they equal to each other? We don't know, right? This could be 3. This could be 7. Would those be congruent triangles? We simply don't know. So this would be an NEI. Not enough information to prove that those two triangles are in fact congruent. How about AC, ABC, and DEF in this case? We have all three angles of the first equal to all three angles of the second, which means we're considering the angle, angle, angle case. Well, our answer then is no, or NEI. We simply do not know if these two guys are congruent. Again, all three angles are equal to all three angles of the second, but that doesn't guarantee that their sides are going to be the same length. Okay, so we have to be extra careful with this one. Angle, angle, angle does not prove congruence. Now let's consider these two triangles, ABC and CDE. Well, take a look. We've already got one pair of sides given to us equal, and actually a second pair of sides given to us equal. And as it turns out, remember, we may assume that if angles appear straight, they are straight, which means we've got ourselves a pair of vertical angles there. Does this then satisfy one of our triangle congruences? Yes, it does. In this case, we're looking at side angle side congruence. Two sides in the included angle of one are equal to two sides in the included angle of the other. So there we have it, a pair of congruent triangles. Now let's take a look at this one. Hey, we do have a pair of equal sides here and a second pair of equal sides here. And again, we have a pair of equal angles here because we may assume that angles that appear straight are straight. So that means we do have a pair of equal angles, right? BCA and ECD are both vertical, which makes them equal. But take a look. These two triangles are actually not congruent, or at least we do not know if there's enough information they're congruent. Because look what pattern they follow. Angle, side, side. Uh-oh. Angle, side, side. So does angle, side, side prove congruence? No. This would lead us to a conclusion of not enough information. We'd need more to either show yes, it is congruent, or no, they are not congruent. Now be careful with this one. Triangle AEB and triangle BDC, are they congruent? Well, we know that these two sides are equal, and we know that these two sides are equal. A lot of students will say, yes, of course they've got to be congruent. Well, we don't know that. Again, this side could be 3, this side here could be 7. Are they congruent to each other? No, right? There's simply not enough information. So we have to be extra careful, okay, jumping to conclusions. Yes, those triangles, it's kind of deceiving. They appear to be the same size, same shape, but we don't know that, okay, based on what information is given. A couple more examples. Let's take a look at this one. We're given that segment AB and segment BC are equal. We're also given that AB, or this line, or segment AC is perpendicular to BD. What that also means is by our perpendicular lines theorem, that we also have this angle over here as being right angle, and the two triangles share a side, BD, which means we have side angle side because right all right angles are, in fact, equal to each other. So we satisfy the side angle side congruence. So yes, those two triangles are, in fact, congruent by side angle side. With the diagram below, ABC, right, the entire triangle, we have ABD and CBD. We're given that AB is equal to BC, and that D is the midpoint of segment AC, which means we can prove that AD and CD are equal to each other. Well, there's actually two ways we can say yes in this one. Let me show you the first obvious way. The two triangles share a common side, which means, yes, we could have used side angle side. But here's what's fun. Because D is the midpoint of AC, right, and we have that straight angle there, ADC, that means the entire triangle, ABC, is actually an isosceles triangle. So what can we say then about the angles opposite those equal sides? We can say those angles are equal, which means we could have also said yes a second way, which was then use the isosceles triangle theorem and side angle side congruence to show that the two triangles are congruent. So that's two ways we could have actually proven that those pairs of triangles were actually congruent to each other. Let's use the same diagram. Let's change the information around a little bit. Given that segment BD bisects angle ABC and that segments BD and AC are perpendicular, let's take a look at how that one unfolds. So BD bisects our angle ABC, which means I can claim these two angles are equal. It's perpendicular to our side there, AC, which means both of those angles are right. And so I know I have another pair of equal angles because all right angles are equal. And as it turns out, they share a common side, BD, which means I can say yes again. It's using our angle side angle congruence, right? Because I have an included pair of sides that are equal. So angle side angle is our congruence for this last slide. So when you hop over to the 3.6 part 1 worksheet, you're going to see very similar questions to this, where I'm going to chuck two triangles at you and ask you, can you prove that the two triangles given to you are in fact congruent? And if you can, you got to tell me why they are congruent. Is it by side angle side, side side side, or angle side angle? If we can't fit it to one of those three, then we'll use our last phrase of NEI, not enough information. If you do have any questions on that worksheet, please do not hesitate to email me. And with that, be good and do good.